Okay, so let's check our work on the global warming game that you just watched Mrs. Shields and I play. And an interesting thing I'll get to at the end is, well, when we play a game, we usually know the rules, which I share with you the procedure for playing, but we also know the goal of the game, like how you win. And so this was never mentioned. So when we get to the end, it'll be more of a discussion about, well, what is winning for the Earth? What are the right atmosphere conditions for our planet to sustain a suitable climate? Okay, but when we think about the game, there were four thinking about the game questions in round one. So check your work here, please. Each bean represented what? The white bean was visible light photon energy packet coming from the sun that we can see. And when there was a switch to a red beam, it was when heat was given off. We call that an infrared photon. So those are the only right answers there. Fix it if necessary. Now, what kind of photon from the sun entered the atmosphere each time it was visible light? Remember, we started with the 12 white beams coming from outer space, coming from the sun and heading to our atmosphere. Now, the right answer that you should have for how many W's for round one was 9. And remember, those W's stand for warming. Now in round two, we changed something. We added carbon dioxide to the atmosphere. Carbon dioxide is really the most important, but not the only greenhouse heat trapping gas. So in round one, we actually had an atmosphere with no heat trapping greenhouse gases at all. Now we added 3, and your score should have been 18 W's, 18 warming events. And then finally, the third round, round three, we doubled the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere from 3 to 6. In that time, we actually had 30 W's after round number 3. So now that we know these results, we want to summarize them and make science sense of them. So what trend do we see in our results? This is super important here. And if it's in blue, that's what you should have typed in or written in. If there's an increase in carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, then there's an increase in warming. Remember, we had no carbon dioxide, 9, then 3 carbon dioxides, 18, and then we went up to 30 in the third round. And now what's the scientific reason for this? Well, it's questions 2 and 3. Did you notice that, let's say visible light hit something on the surface, say a spider, and the spider absorbed the photon and it was warmed up a bit and we changed to infrared. But then when that infrared photon went to leave the atmosphere, there was nothing to stop it. So an infrared photon can only warm the Earth once if there's no carbon dioxide or no other greenhouse gases present. Now you might be thinking, wait, I can kind of remember Mrs. Shields got 2 W's on one turn. Do you remember she got absorbed by another object next door? So that was really a separate infrared photon. So the right answer there is once. But do you remember how I had a turn in round 3 that was super annoying? Honestly, I could not get out. I had my visible light photon. I went to Earth's surface because remember, I could go through the carbon dioxide when it was visible light. But then I was absorbed by something and I hit a carbon dioxide molecule with an infrared. Then I went back down. Then I came back up and I hit another and another. And so I think I had 6 or 7 W's just on one turn. And here's the thing. Carbon dioxide can do double duty, so to speak, meaning that one carbon dioxide can trap heat, can trap an infrared photon, not just once, but several times. And that's really why carbon dioxide can be this powerful greenhouse gas. Okay, so now, what about this? I know this was a hard question. And in the past, students have wanted to ride the fence. And they've wanted to say, well, it's kind of good and kind of bad. Oh, no, it isn't. Is the greenhouse effect good or bad? Look at that red answer there. The greenhouse effect is good. And here's the science. If we had no heat-trapping gases, Earth would just be too cold. Okay, so then what is winning, right? And I think of it like Goldilocks. Goldilocks didn't want her porridge too hot, but she didn't want it too cold. So the round that's really best for our planet is round number 2, where we have the right amount or a moderate amount of greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide, but not out of control. That would be round 3. Now, what about this? Is round 1 okay? No, too cold of a planet. So when we get to round 3, that's when scientists call it global warming, or sometimes you hear the term climate change, and that's the environmental issue. It's not an issue to have some greenhouse gases in our atmosphere. That is a good thing. It's an issue when they're out of control. That's an important distinction to make. Now, How might scientists use a game like this in real life? Do I really think climate scientists are sitting around with red and white beans? No. But do I know for a fact that scientists are using models, computer models, to predict global temperatures based on potential carbon dioxide increases? Absolutely. And that's really important, that these models in predicting policy. I was just reading that scientists have looked back at models and predictions that were made in 2000 about 2020, and they've been right on the money or super, super close. So this idea of modeling what will happen is a major important thing that climate scientists do. And it's kind of similar to our game.